Okay, so if you happen to be throwing a punch, she has to be ready because I may throw this punch at any time and get into this position. Now, people are thinking, what good is this wrist lock? What good is that against somebody who's much stronger? I'm a guy. I can do all this. Okay, well, it's actually pretty, and they're pretty nice. I know how to work out of the majority of locks. I'm not going to demonstrate that today, but if I were, it was going to be a matter of leverage and changing angles to make this work. But the other point is, this just holds the person for the police, and that's fine. If, for instance, I have another buddy who's going to come help me, she needs to take me out fast. She needs to make sure that I can't follow her or do something else. So this isn't going to do as much right off the bat. Yes, she can hyperextend my elbow joint at this point. She's got a really good bead on that. She can do two things. She can tear my wrist right there, and she can pop the elbow joint itself. That doesn't stop me from my legs working. It doesn't stop me from my eyes being able to track her, that sort of thing. So, what else do we do? In this case, she has her back elbow, so it's not just about that we're using the locks themselves to finish a fight. We're using them as a control mechanism to help establish a base and foundation for distributing your other attacks. So in this case, it's an elbow. She can do that. She can slam that repeatedly, or just one good time in the right place. Or she can just backhand it and start working towards my throat, just like that, and she can start causing problems with my breathing. Or she goes backhanding it to my eyes, my breathing, and takes care of some of that to make sure that it's harder for me to see and breathe and chase after her. And then the other thing also is strikes. So she could just hammer fist in back like that, just repeatedly. And again, if you do it on the nose, you do it in the eye socket, things like that, it's harder to see. So she wants to establish those really quickly. But the other thing, if she also just covers my face with her, there you go, and the eyes, and I can't see. So she wants to really, you know, dig in, do whatever else. It's a setup for the other hand that releases the lock. As she pulls this one away, bam, she sets it into play, okay? So the lock isn't the end-all to a fight. Just like a groin strike isn't the end-all to a fight. They're tools in a toolbox. They are something to get you from one position to the next, and sometimes next is just escape. So in this case, you can see there was a variety of things that the arm lock, the wrist lock, the elbow lock, those sort of things facilitated, enabled. Okay, so they're enabling tools. All right, any other questions? You know where to find me.